Welcome to Colgate Palmolive. So, as you have requested for the meeting with us for discussing the investment proposal in our company, so we have made a basic presentation about our company profile. So, let's go through the profile and then we will answer your whatever queries you have about the proposal.
Yes.
Yeah. So, Aparna now take it forward for us.
So, as you know, Colgate Palmolive, we are in the fast-moving consumer goods industry. We were founded way back in 1806, and we market over more than 200 countries and territories. And our primary focus of our company is on oral care and pet care and nutrition. Our market share currently in the toothpaste industry is around 45%, and we are world number one in the oral care segment, and also the sixth largest in the home care manufacturing. Our returns as on date has been improving by the day. We have reported a net profit of $2,241 million in 2013, and our EPS for the year 2013 has been $2 per equity share. The market price is also been very good, with it being at $65, and the market cap as on date is around $62 billion. To talk about our valuation of the company, we have looked at the PE ratios of the other companies in the industry versus our company. If you look at Nestlé, they have a price earnings of around 19. If you look at Procter and Gamble, they have around 24. Coca-Cola and Unilever have around 20. Our current price to earnings ratio is at 23.75. And this does indicate that we have a high potential to generate better earnings in the future as compared to our rivals in the industry. Also, our price to book ratio is at 38, which is very high. Also shows that our company shares are not undervalued. The current market price is at 67, which indicates that the business is profitable and sustainable. Let's look at the liquidity of our company. If you can look at the presentation, the cash flow statement as well as the profits of the company on comparison, we can see that the cash generated from operations has been positive all through these years, and that funds that we generate from our operations are being used to fund our financing and investment activities. The profit after tax has been 2,000 million. The cash flow from operations has been about 3,000 million. And the investing and financing activities, being a part of the FMCG sector, the sectors as such, you would know that there are no great fluctuations in the earnings. It is a stable industry, and we have been making stable profits. We do have a positive working capital and a current ratio of greater than 1. The liquidity ratio is at 0.76, and the absolute cash ratio is at 0.39. So the cash position, the absolute cash position is at around 0.4. But if you look at our working capital turnover days, our debtor days and creditor days, we are way below the industry average. We are able to collect from our debtors and pay to our creditors in a cycle and turn around our cash at a faster rate. The current assets are being financed by non-current sources, since the working capital ratio is greater than 1. We are a debt-driven company as of now. 20% of our total long-term sources is equity, and balance is debt-driven. We have a high interest coverage ratio, way above the industry average. We are servicing our debt on time, and we'll be doing that in the future. The current credit rating of our company is AA-, which has been given by Fitch. Almost 70% of our assets are financed by non-current sources, mainly non-current liabilities. The retained earnings to the total assets is greater than 1, which indicates that our company is profitable even after distributing the profits to the shareholders. And the assets that are employed in the business are being used to generate profits. Secondly, the the return on investment on our company's stock today is extremely high. The return on equity, which is of great use to you, is at 88%. The return on capital employed is at 38%, and the return on total assets is at 26%. The company does have the ability to generate as well as distribute profits to its shareholders. We are one of the only companies which has distributed dividends to shareholders for the past 100 years without any being missed. We also conducted a DuPont analysis so that the profitability position of our company is clearer to you. If you can have a look at the presentation, the DuPont analysis shows the various breakups of the profits of the company broken down into the operating decisions, the financing decisions, and the investment decisions. The net profit is positive, and in comparison to the industry average, we are way above the industry average. And the major contributor to our ROE is the financing decisions made by the company, which is as a result of the strong operation efficiency of the company. The interest burden is high, but forming part of the operating expenses, but as I've said before, our interest coverage ratio is higher and we are servicing our debts on time. The cost of goods sold forms nearly 40% of the operating expenses. The fixed asset turnover ratio, inventory turnover ratio, as well as the receivables turnover ratio is high. And we do have a strong credit policy and we're able to collect our dues on time. The economic value added of our company today stands at around $2,000 million. Also, as a part of our deal that we can negotiate about, we do intend to gain a lot of ideas as well as your experiences to add to our managerial efficiency and to smoothen our business operations.
Okay. I have a list of questions for you.
Okay.
First of all, I want to ask you, what is the current market position of this company? And is the company gaining any market share, and what is the gaining percentage of the market share?
Mr. Gupta, currently our company is one of the biggest in oral care market. We have around 45% market share in oral care. We are a little low in the pet nutrition sector. That's our second big area. That's something that we're hoping to improve on. Our market capitalization is over $62 billion right now, and we are present all over the world. Our distribution is amongst the best in the world, so that's something that we are hoping to capitalize. We are the number one oral care company and the sixth largest home care manufacturer. So we have some of the biggest brands with us, Colgate, Palmolive, etc. So that's a snapshot.
Okay. Are the company earnings justified when it compares to the invested capital that is there in the company? What, as a shareholder, I want to know if I invest my money into it, are the earnings going to be justified to get me the return?
To answer your question, the price earnings ratio of our company is at 23.75, which is way above the industry average. The other companies in the same industry are giving you lesser returns than what we would give you. The return on equity also stands at around 89% today, which shows
that... What is the difference between your company's PE ratios as well as your competitors?
Our competitors, for example, Nestle has a PE ratio of 19.5. Procter & Gamble has a PE ratio of 24. Coca-Cola has a PE ratio of 20. Unilever today has a PE ratio of 19. And Kraft Foods has a PE ratio of 18. And we have a PE ratio of 24,
okay.
which shows the high earnings potential of our company.
Okay.
And to the equity investor, we do believe in creating wealth for you, and we have been doing that, which is proven by our ROE, indicating that there are high returns generated by employing our assets.
You said that your interest burden is high. Could you tell me what is the interest rates that you're paying in terms of long-term loans?
The interest rates that we are paying on an average is at 2% currently. The amount of debt that we have is high, but since our interest coverage ratio is also very high, we are able to service our debts. If you could see on the slide on the interest coverage ratio, the industry average is at 14 and we have an interest coverage ratio of 31.73, which is way above what the industry norm is, and that is why we are very confident that we can service our debts on time and the long term debt is not going to be a problem for the equity investor.
Okay. So basically I also want to know, since I'm going to be one of the part of your company, I want to know what is the long-term strategic plan of this company.
As my friend stated earlier, we currently having a 45% market share in the toothpaste industry, and we are world number one in the oral care sector. We wish to expand our hold in the pet care sector that we are currently having a hold right now in, but we want to expand in that, and that's our long-term strategy, that we want to expand our hold in the pet care sector and increase our share in the oral care sector as well.
You basically are going to focus more energies on the pet
care sector. Yes.
Okay. I also want to know what would be the structure and form we expect this partnership to happen.
Actually, we are thinking of giving you new equity shares so that you can invest on it.
Okay. So, what is the current equity ratio? Debt equity ratio.
The current debt equity ratio is at
2.71.
Yeah. Okay.
And the current percentage of equity as a part of our total non-current sources is at 20%, and the industry norm being at a lower debt equity, it would be beneficial to our company as well as for you, since our return on equity is higher. So, and a new issue of equity shares would be beneficial to both of us.
Okay. So you're gonna issue new equity shares.
Fresh equity shares. Yeah.
Okay. The last question that my partners as well as me will ask you is, what value does my private equity firm add to the brand Colgate as well as?
Yeah, Mr. Gupta, as you know that we are already the number one in the oral care sector, and we are expanding in the pet care sector, but the one sector we are lagging behind is the consumer goods, where we are lagging in terms of Unilever and Procter & Gamble are ahead. So in that sector we want to diversify, and with the knowledge and expertise with your company having, so which you will bring on board, so that will help us to expertise and expand, and together as we can take this firm forward in this sector.
Okay, I'll get back to you by doing the due financial diligence as well as the legal aspect of it. Okay.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you so much.